Set up predictive cash forecasting so that you can make better use of your cash with data-driven continuous cash forecasting. Use predictive cash forecasting to more accurately forecast cash inflows and outflows, thereby ensuring your company has enough liquidity to meet its financial obligations and strategic goals. This video is the second video in a series for setting up predictive cash forecasting. Related videos are linked in the description. In this video, we will look at the steps required to set up the forecast range and time horizon. Consider both the short-term daily forecast and medium-term periodic forecast when setting up the time granularity for predictive cash forecasting. Each of these forecasts are independent models that satisfy different needs for managing cash. The short-term cash forecast is focused on immediate cash needs to ensure that there is enough cash for the next few days. The goal is to set this up so that the process is completely automated and accuracy levels are near 100%. You also want to ensure that there are no surprises for both working capital, operational cash, as well as important and significant investments or financing cash flows over the next few days. Setting up a daily cash forecast allows you to review the previous day's actuals and compare that with what was forecasted, thereby enabling you to take quick action, making adjustments to the cash forecast for the days immediately following. The medium-term forecast focuses on the view of cash over the next few periods for working capital, operational cash flow needs, as well as investing or financing needs. Predictive cash forecasting supports both monthly and weekly rolling forecast options. Creating weekly forecasts allows more flexibility for changes to the forecasts where you can modify decisions based on the weekly progress. Select monthly when there is a longer cash cycle, such as when your business is project-based. Select weekly for more volatile businesses or when there is ongoing business, such as with consumer goods, products, or services businesses. Take care to select the right periodic forecast, either monthly or weekly, as you cannot change this selection later. Setting the application to a 13-week rolling forecast or a 6-month rolling forecast is ideal. 13 weeks represent a quarter and is a reasonable time horizon, especially if you forecast cash from customer invoices, where the accuracy is high in the initial 4 to 6 weeks and reduces thereafter. Controllers are key users of the medium-term forecast, as they review the forecast and suggest important actions such as accelerating collections, managing payment expectations, planning for tax payments, and inter-entity transfers for optimizing cash across entities within a region. Set up the forecast range. Use the system date for your environments. When the start day is a future day, such as when you are not yet in production or you need to take holidays into account, you can specify a start date that is not beyond 30 days of the system date. With every daily maintenance window, the date rolls over. The current rolled over date and data becomes the forecast start date, and the previous day becomes the actuals. These changes are reflected in the rolling forecast form. Select the number of forecast days. The rolling forecast is updated based on the forecast start day and the number of forecast days. Define the number of actual days for variances and reporting. The actual rolling forecast range is updated based on the forecast start day and the number of actual days. Even though the actual date range displays based on your selection, you can upload more historical periods for actual data if you have it. Set the number of forecast periods. The rolling forecast range is updated based on the forecast start day and the number of forecast periods. Define the number of actual periods for variances and reporting. The actual rolling forecast range is updated based on the forecast start day and the number of actual periods. Based on the forecast range, substitution variables and valid intersection combinations are updated. Also, the rolling forecast form and some of the historical variance forms and dashboards include date ranges based on the forecast range setup. Keep in mind, if you change the forecast range, you must run the daily forecast and periodic forecast rules again to see the change reflected in the rolling forecast form. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.